Turning to Queensland's bushfire emergency, and right now there are several blazes burning across the state with an emergency level warning in Tara. Today, Queensland reporter Ashlyn Krukellis is across developments for us. Ashlyn, firefighters have had a busy night.
Yeah, they have, Lizzie. They have been working relentlessly for days now. It's estimated there are around 90 fires burning across Queensland. Of course, they vary in size. But the main centre of this emergency continues to be Queensland's Western Downs. There is still that emergency warning in place for Tara, Weambilla and the Gums. Residents in those areas are urged to evacuate immediately. There's also a long list of watch and act and advice warnings in place. One of them is for Landsborough between Brisbane and the Sunshine Coast. The fire there flared up last night. At one point, it was at an emergency level with residents being urged to evacuate. Some major roads, including the Steve Irwin Way, was closed. Thankfully, that fire is now contained, so that's now at an advice level, mainly for all the smoke that's in the area, and people around Brisbane will notice that smoke this morning too. The focus today, though, will once again be in the Western Downs. The fire there, unfortunately, is just not letting up. It's estimated around 63,000 hectares of land has been burned there. The latest information we have this morning is that 40 homes have been lost and 25 sheds. Unfortunately, that number is expected to rise. There are around 300 residents who've been evacuated to the nearby towns of Dalby and Chinchilla. The situation remains very dangerous.
It's just data there that's taken off. There's a guy in there trying to put it out. He needs help.
I need to really stress that this is a dynamic situation still.
The weather has actually been kinder to firefighters this weekend. The temperature's down, winds have eased, but still gusts come along that will carry embers and then another fire will start up again. What crews are really worried about at the moment is the forecast for Tuesday. It is expected to rise into the high 30s again with dry conditions and strong northerly winds. So, Lizzie, they're really trying to do everything they can to get the upper hand today and tomorrow before that bad weather moves in on Tuesday.
With more than 80 bushfires currently burning right the way across Queensland and record temperatures expected through summer, climate experts are now on high alert. Professor Rick McRae is one of them, and he's developed this new bushfire warning system in the hope of saving lives and land. He joins us live from Canberra. Professor, thanks for your time on Weekend Today. Tell us about this system you've crafted.
Well, thank you for your time. What we have been pondering ever since the 2003 fires in the Alpine area of New South Wales, Victoria and the ACT is why the fires were behaving differently to what we expected. And what we've learnt since through an awful lot of fundamental science is that there is a different type of bushfire happening. And the traditional ones we really are on top of. Our fire services do a great job handling them. But this new one, we need to have tools to allow us to adapt to the impacts they're having and do whatever we can to keep our communities safe.
Sure. So, Professor, it's probably too late for a lot of the Queensland families right now fleeing their homes. But had this system been in place months ago, would things be different?
For the people in Queensland, it wouldn't be different at all. That's because what they have there is the normal type of fire, and it's being impacted by climate change. So what we're seeing all around the country is most fires are changing in their frequency, intensity, and the damage they're causing. On top of that, you've got this new type of fire. We have seen one or two candidates in Queensland. A week ago, we saw the first confirmed tropical one in Australia on record. And that's a bad sign because tropical ones have only really been found globally in the last half a dozen years. That's another impact of climate change. But for Queensland, yes, it is hot, dry and windy, and people have to do everything they can to keep safe. What we're focusing on with the new system is the forested hilly country basically between Brisbane and Melbourne, and that includes Canberra, and we're currently looking to see how much it includes Tasmania, the eucalypt forests are the areas that are most affected.
Right, so that system, that technology, it's being trialled right now. How long before we can actually start using it, do you think?
Well, it's on the website now. It is basically a developed system. We're trying to test how it performs as we go forward, but so far it has performed quite well. It's predicted the sort of extreme wildfires that we have seen so far in the southeast, and we've run the system backwards over 20 years and it's performed pretty much flawlessly, so we've got a high confidence that it'll be a usable system.
Well, it could be a long, hot, dry summer. Thanks so much for joining us and for your insight this morning, Professor Rick McRae there in Canberra.
Now to the bushfire emergency in Queensland, with more than 80 fires burning across the state overnight. Hundreds of residents have been told to evacuate their homes, with others on standby amid emergency warnings. At least 35 homes have already been destroyed. And for more, we are joined by QFES Deputy Commissioner Joanne Greenfield. Deputy Commissioner, good morning to you. Tell us, what is the latest on the situation there on the ground?
Good morning. So our crews have been working into the night and we've got warnings up and down the state, right from Cooktown to Mount Isa down to the New South Wales border. We've got three fires of significance at the moment at Tara, at Biwa and at Lowmead. So the crews have been working incredibly hard. The conditions will ease slightly today and then we expect them to escalate again on Tuesday. So we'll be working hard on containment lines today.
And we're not even in summer yet. How concerned are you that this is only the beginning?
You're right. It is an early season for us, but we planned well. We were prepared. We knew back in August, given the warnings we were getting from the Bureau of Meteorology and the conditions here, that we were in for a big season. So we worked hard to prepare, to train, worked hard on mitigation. But we are working on planning to make sure we're moving resources around the state, and we've called for interstate resources as well, just to make sure we can sustain the effort throughout the summer period.
And this is a warning if residents ever need one, these pictures we're seeing now. How can residents at risk now prepare?
That's right. So we're putting a lot of information out into the community and through our warnings, so really tune into those. Those people who've been evacuated, not to return until you get the all clear. The fire grounds still aren't safe. And for those that are close to fires, to keep the radio tuned in, to keep watching on our Facebook and social media for the warnings. Make sure your bushfire plan's in place and that you've gone through it with your family.
Yeah, our thoughts are with the crews on the ground and all of those residents affected. Deputy Commissioner, thank you for your time this morning.
Firefighters have spent the night battling blazes across Queensland, with dozens of properties in Tara destroyed by the flames. Nine's Olivana Lathouris is in Tara for us this morning. Ollie, you've just received an update. What can you tell us?
Jane, we have fire crews here in Tara have told us a little bit of good news. Weather conditions were favourable overnight, which allowed them to conduct some tactical backburns and work on strengthening some of those containment lines. Even still, the fire here in Tara remains at emergency level this morning. Residents in Tara, Weambela and the Gum still urged to leave immediately. Several watch and act warnings also remain in place in surrounding areas. Also on the Sunshine Coast, the communities of Landsborough and Biwa were issued an emergency warning last night, although that has now been revoked. That fire is no longer threatening properties. We did have the Deputy Commissioner of the Queensland Fire and Emergency Services on the show a little earlier this morning. Here's a bit of what he had to say.
So our crews have been working into the night and we've got warnings up and down the state. So the crews have been working incredibly hard. The conditions will ease slightly today and then we expect them to escalate again on Tuesday. So we'll be working hard on containment lines. It is an early season for us, but we planned well, we were prepared.
That blaze here in Tara has now burnt through more than 14,000 hectares of land. More than 40 homes have been lost, and sadly, that number is expected to rise today and in the coming days. As you just heard there, hopefully some slightly easier conditions for our exhausted fire crews here on the ground today. Although no doubt there is much more of this disaster yet to come, and it's going to be a difficult week ahead.